So, I've been shopping. Like half the insulation I need, but I'm only planning on putting the sides in. So I got some ply for that, some 9mm ply, hardwood ply to go in on the bottom half of the sides. And then I got ply and some joinery timber to go and start building the wet roof, which is going to be a massive pain. It's going to be really difficult, but I think I can get it right.
Come over here for a second. I need to introduce you to the camera. Stand right there. Hey everybody, this is my friend Martha.
No, not like that.
She's going to help me today. We're going to cut some... We're going to play with my wood. Okay, great.
So last night varnished up the bathroom components with my friend Martha, and like fair play, she stuck around for ages. We got the job done, but we did it with these size brushes, which is a right old pain. So today I'm gonna use this. Call that a brush? This is a brush. That's all I can really do today. I've coated the bathroom thing walls again. I just found something really great online that I'm going to use for the interior. Originally I was going to put Perspex in so you could see the wood effect, but It's just going to be just a huge hassle on trying to keep that watertight. So I found some cladding that's designed for wet rooms. It comes in sheets between 200 and 375 mil wide, so it's going to be perfect, especially for cutting out shapes. And I get some trim and things and sort that. It's going to take a while to get delivered, so I'm going to have to work on it right away. So today I've got a wrestling show tonight, so I've got to get to the gym, sort myself out, shave. So unfortunately that's all I got to do today. But tomorrow and Saturday can be some big days.
Big days. Yeah.
Okay, right, Dan and I are gonna build the bathroom unit, the wet room unit. I got the exterior ply to go. I've ordered the cladding, the wet room cladding to go inside. So we need to build the framework up. It also needs the framework because that's what I'm gonna mount the water heater to. And then I need to cut the flue vent for that one too. So we need to get that done. And then we can also find the position of the wet room, can't we, Dan?
Yeah.
And then we can drill the drain into the floor of that as well, which I don't know if I'm gonna get done today, but or tomorrow, because I'm busy, and then I'm busy for the rest of the week, so. Well, it would be nice to get it done, but I don't think we're gonna manage it. Unless you're super duper. Okay, cool. Varnish the wall the wrong way round. I've got to do the whole thing again. Twice now. God, two coats. Just because I didn't think. Stupid. And that's not... I could flip it around, but this is not tall enough to... Danny!
What?
What are we doing?
No!
Wet breaker! Right. Sorry, mate. Alright, so I'm gonna try and stick it where it's supposed to go. I know that that's gonna be in the way. There's a little bar up there, I don't know if you can see it, but I'm gonna put the unit where it needs to go, cut out the back bits that need to get cut out, and obviously cut out the unit where there's anything that's structural on the van that needs to get in. So this is the technical bit. So I need to get it back by that much, 2 inches, right? So I need to chop out some bits.
Parfait!
actually fall another inch or so that way if I take out a bit of this where the vent is coming through, which actually makes it easier for me to try and get this vent accessible from the shower. Yeah, sure, cut that out now. So that's in place.
I'm going to show you this. So we're left with there. Toilet access. Brilliant.
And that's where you fill up the flush.
And that's the shower vent behind it, which I will cut into the wet room soon. Monza.
Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. If you did enjoy it, please don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm just dropping you a quick note because I've just set up a Patreon account. And if you're not sure what that is, it's a way for you guys to help me out and get these videos uploaded much quicker. Because right now I'm showing you stuff from 2, maybe 3 months ago, and you're nowhere near up to date. The only place you can see it right now is Instagram, @MotoringHome, well up to date there. But here you go, here's the Patreon link, that's how the YouTubers do it, right there. So yeah, check it out. See you again, peace out, yo.